when is the best time to resign. Mm-hmm. Syempre may mga nandun na sila sa ganong situation. Mm-hmm. So ano yung mga advice pala natin sa kanila?
Okay, when you think you're ready, ang suggestion ko is itetest mo muna yung waters.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, if there's a way for you na makapag-leave sa company, let's say 10 days, 12 days, or a few months, para itest mo, okay, just for that span of time, gawin mo itong gusto mong gawin.
Okay.
I actually did it in 2011. I felt I was ready.
Mm-hmm.
So I tested the waters. So 2011, I took a 2 months leave, special leave, without pay. And for the next 2 months, yun, ay ginagawa ako full-time yung nagsusulat, ganyan. So, sobrang excited ako kasi yun yung, wow, buffet writing. Di ba? Hindi ko kailangan pumasok. From sun up to sun down, nagsusulat ako. And then, alam mo yung result nun after 2 months? Boredom.
Mm-hmm.
For the next few months, ayoko na magsulat.
Mm-hmm.
Nasukang-suka na ako sa pagsusulat. So, imagine if I quit my job right there and then. Nawala kaagad ako, nawala ako sa purpose ko and all. So, before you resign, you have to check, okay, kaya ko na, if there's a way for you to test the waters, gawin mo yan.
Yeah, okay.
Of course, you're already doing it on the side, diba? That's the ideal na gagawin mo siya on the side, to check mo na, pag ito may potential ng ang laki ng income mo dito, yun, pwede ka na talaga mag-resign. Next is, the best time to quit is when you're financially prepared, financially ready. Hindi lang na may pera kang nakalaan na 6 months or 12 months, but ikaw mismo, marunong kang mag-manage ng pera mo. You know how to manage what little you have or what much you have. And then next is, it's the best time to quit your job if also you're emotionally ready at kaya mo nang panindigan yung decision mo.
Okay.
Yan.
Perfect. What about you, Sian?
Ako, for me, di ba kung may mapapansin nyo, maraming nag-stay sa company for 10 years, 15 years, tapos mag-resign lang din sila 20 years kasi they keep on waiting for the best time.
Mm-hmm.
Nakatawang isipin mo yung mga teachers back before way back high school na during the graduation, inawardan siya ng 40 years of service. What? Seriously? You stayed here for 40 years throughout your life? So maybe that's their passion. Mm-hmm. Pero going on the part na may mga 20 years na sa work tapos nag-resign pa.
Yeah.
Because they keep on waiting for the best time and technically, there's really no such thing as best time. Yeah. Because you define your own best time.
Yeah. Life is now.
I mean, life is now in a way that you define your own best time, not being too much idealistic, but you prepare yourself in which na katulad nung kay mom siya that pinrepare niya yung 18 months niya.
Mm-mm.
Pero basically, the advice is really 6 months.
Mm-mm.
And then prepare mo na rin yung boat mo after resigning, something like that. So for me, you define your best time in a way that you really decide first sa sarili mo. Because when you're, pakapag decided ka na sa sarili mo, everything will follow na in preparing yourself towards that day of that you've been waiting for the rest of your life, and that's your filing your resignation.
That's a very nice advice yung kay Sian, kasi sabi nga nila, diba, we have our own clock, okay? Kasi kung yung society yung gusto mo na at the age of 20, at the age of 25 kailangan manager ka na, at the age of 30 kailangan yun ito, kung yun yung susundin mo, you're not really living. Kasi for example, may mga nag-resign na, susundin mo na sila, o kaya naman nag-change na sila, nasa abroad na yung friend mo. Feeling mo, kailangan mag-abroad ka na rin at the age of na ganito. Eh, alam mo, yun yung may car na yung friend mo at the age of 20. So, may mga tao kasi na ganun, nape-pressure sila dun sa norms ng society na parang kailangan mangyari din sa akin to. So, tanggalin mo muna yon, okay? Focus ko ano talaga yung priority mo, okay? Mm-hmm. So, for example, ang priority mo ngayon, makagraduate yung mga sisters, okay? Mga siblings mo. Kaya naman, ma-pay off mo yung car, kaya naman yung mga debts, mga ganun. Kailangan meron ka munang priority, and then, di ba sabi nga ni Susie Orman, kailangan unahin mo yung mga kaya mo munang bayaran. Like, mga small debts muna para makross na sila ng list. Tapos, habang tumatagal, makakuha ka na ng mga opportunities and you are actually buying more time to pursue your passion or hone your skills na pwede ka mag-earn ng income doon.
Diba? Yeah, tsaka di ba sinabi nga ni na Michelle, and when you decide on it na panindigan mo siya.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. You need to have a solid big why on why you are doing it. Correct. Para even the going gets tough, you're ready. And yung tipong hindi mo aatrasan, babalik ka din pala to where you started na employee ka, diba?
Correct, correct.
Mm-hmm. And have the balls really to accept the circumstances of your decision.
Correct.
Yeah, it's not always positive. There will always be times na ma-hit mo yung rock bottom, but it's not about how many times you failed, it's how many times you bounced back.
Yes.
Diba? Resilience.
Mm-hmm.
And then you cannot blame it on other people.
Yes.
Nag-fail. It's on you. It's always on you. So